Incredible! I've never seen such an intense magnetic field. What's going on?
Again. I was researching at Stonehenge with my colleagues when there was an explosion. Some kind of extreme magnetic anomaly. Honestly, it's best if you come see it yourself. We need your expertise. Please hurry.
Hello, Detective. I'm Agent David Redford, MI6. I've read about your previous adventure, and it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. I believe your sister may be innocent. Come, we've much to discuss. Stonehenge is closed to the public. You look like the person I spoke to, but I'd like to see your ID to confirm your identity. You understand, I'm sure. Thank you, Detective. I appreciate your cooperation. You may call me David. As you can see, we're currently dealing with two unique anomalies. They're beginning to spread at a rapid rate, one threatening to burn everything in its path, and the other to freeze it. We're hoping you can help us make sense of this. Stonehenge itself is currently blocked by an energy barrier. We can't get anything past it. I'm certain whatever is causing these anomalies is inside that barrier. Your sister is inside this tent. You may see her now.
Oh, you made it. Sorry I didn't tell you about this sooner, but I couldn't pass up an internship at Stonehenge. The past few days, we've been detecting strong fluctuations of magnetic activity coming from Stonehenge. The explosion happened early this morning. Agent Redford saved me. But everyone else... They're gone. I'm sorry. It's just been a long day, but having you here really helps. I'm confident you'll find a way to stop this. I mean, you've saved other worlds, right? Here's what I brought with me. Let's check on the anomalies outside first.
Thank you.
As you can see, the ice and fire are expanding at an exponential rate. If you don't hurry, they could cause irreversible damage. I guess the sedative the EMT gave me is finally kicking in. Here, take this. It's the device we were using to protect ourselves from the magnetic field. It's the reason I survived.
Thank you.
So there really was another world beyond that portal. Great idea using that copter to go in first. That world seems to be stable enough for exploration. Given your expertise, I'd like to enter the portal first. Don't worry, I have just the thing to keep you from freezing in there. Take this key. You'll find an environmental suit inside the locker.
Thank you. stranger. You appeared just after the cold began. Did you cause this? Oh. If your intentions are pure, our sacred Scappy know. Bring me a Scappy. It will reveal your true intentions. But first you must pass the wall of plants. This guiding powder will help you. Spirits of elders sent you to save our world. You are destined to save our land from this cold. Oh. I am Brigitte. My people have not always lived here. We came from your world long ago, yearning for the eternal summer here. Living here has softened us, making us vulnerable. This cold has made many of us ill. An ancient legend once mentioned a cure for a cold such as this, but we would need to visit the mountains across the river to find it. But this cold is dangerous. Animals that thrive in the cold have appeared in our land. One of them is hunting close to our village. We have been unable to stop it. Come with me. Maybe the tree spirits can tell you how to handle this beast. Oh. This is the sacred tree of my people. It holds our entire history. I beg you to listen to its words. This is how the spirits of our ancestors speak to us. Do not worry. If you have a pure soul, you will hear their voices. A 1,000 years ago, the druids lived on Earth. They worshipped trees and lived in harmony with nature. Druids could speak to plants and animals, maintaining nature's delicate balance. But then the warlike Vikings arrived, yearning to conquer the druids' fruitful lands. The druid shaman and the Viking shaman managed to prevent a bloody war, building Stonehenge as part of a pact. Stonehenge, the shaman opened two portals, a world of eternal cold and a world of fiery lava. neither was habitable until the shamans created two crystals, the ice crystal and the fire crystal. When these crystals were placed on the platform, the worlds began to exchange temperatures through icy and fiery winds. As the temperatures became balanced, people saw the worlds transform into green paradises. Thus, the Vikings went to one world and the Druids to the other, stepping through the portal. To seal these worlds and preserve their climates, Stonehenge was destroyed by the volunteers who wished to stay on Earth. The Druids blossomed in this ideal world where trees grew tall as mountains. The Druid shaman found a remote cave, sealing the ice crystal to preserve the balance of this world.
were sure I would perish. I must return this scepter to our druidess at our main tree. I had just finished repairing it when the code knocked me down. You're seeking the sacred cave, are you not? Bring me home, and I will help you reach it. Thank you again for saving my life. This is my family. They are very shy around strangers. My name is Anuel. A terrible disaster fell upon us. This unending cold attacked us like a fierce beast. For generations, we have lived in peace with nature. Ancestors, how will we survive?